Dozens of Chinese maritime militia ships and a Chinese Coast Guard vessel spotted in the vicinity of Sandy Keys in the West Philippine Sea. The presence of Chinese ships were monitored as personnel of the Bureau of Fisheries and Aquatic Resources conducted an aerial survey of the West Philippine Sea. Sandy Keys are sandbars near Pagasa Island, the largest inhabited island in Kalayaan, Palawan. The BFAR also flew near the China-occupied Subi or Zamora Reef, where it received several radio challenges from Beijing's Coast Guard.
Mahalagang Sandy Keys sa atin, no? Dahil alam naman natin na ang isla ng Pag-asa ay nag-generate ng territorial sea. That means we have territorial sea and full sovereignty dito sa area na to. So as far as the Philippine government is concerned, we are still ensuring, no, na mapapatuloyan natin ito. Nagpapatunay lamang ito na wala pa namang katotohanan yung sinasabing Chinese have already taken control of this Sandy Keys.
Meanwhile, the Philippine Coast Guard says no Filipino fisherman has been detained since China implemented a new policy in June against what it deemed as foreign trespassers. Turning now to the environmental disaster in the province of Bataan. The owner of the sunken oil tanker, MTKR Terranova, denies allegations it was involved in oil smuggling. Porta Vega Ship Management says it has complete documents to prove the legality of its operations, adding it never had any record of complaints from clients. The company also gave assurance it will not evade its responsibilities and obligations to those affected by the oil spill.
We only deal with reputable oil companies. Wala kaming ibang siniserve kundi yung mga meron lang kaming kontrata at yung kakontrata namin ay reputable oil companies.
Salvage operations continue for the MKTR Jason Bradley, another sunken tanker off the province. Meanwhile, the Philippine Coast Guard says the owner of the MV Mirola 1, who abandoned the vessel after it ran aground at Mariveles, Bataan, is no longer cooperating with authorities. Nearly 800 liters of oil-water mixture and 5 bags of contaminated oil debris have been collected from the ship.
It did not pass through the Coast Guard. Sailed on its own, hindi po nagpaalam. That ship is more problematic than Jason Bradley because the owner has been uncooperative. They're not reaching out to the Coast Guard.
An ally of Vice President Sara Duterte wants her to be allowed to handpick her own police security detail. Senator Ronald De La Rosa made the request to National Police Chief General Romel Marbil at the hearing of the Senate Public Order Committee. De La Rosa says the Vice President feels uncomfortable that she's not familiar with any of the 31 police still assigned to protect her. The senator urged Marbil to allow Duterte to select police from her Davao City hometown. Marbil clarified the police officers were selected by the Presidential Security Command, but he agrees that the vice president should have a say in choosing her police security.
Wala po siyang threat. Wala po kami nakita. He's being loved by our people. The security of the president and the vice president lies on the Presidential Security Command. If the General Morales from the PSC asked our help to ask for more personnel, then we will give po.
Over a dozen Davao City police officers relieved for failing to arrest fugitive televangelist Apollo Quiboloy. A Senate panel is investigating the claims of Quiboloy's followers. The police committed overkill in their attempt to serve an arrest warrant for the pastor. RG Cruz reports.
15 cops have been administratively relieved for failing to implement the arrest warrant against Apollo Quiboloy. This was revealed during Monday's hearing of the Senate Committee on Public Order and Dangerous Drugs. The committee is looking into allegations that the government used excessive force in serving the arrest warrants on Quiboloy and 5 others on June 10th. They are wanted by authorities for child abuse and qualified trafficking. National Police Chief General Romel Marbil and other PNP officials also faced off with members of the Quiboloy-led Kingdom of Jesus Christ. The KOJC maintains Quiboloy is not evading arrest.
He has always said it. He's not evading the law. Sinabi na yan ni Pastor, huwag lang makialam ang Amerika. I-secure nyo lang yung seguridad ni Pastor. Haharapin niya lahat ng accusations niya sa korte.
KOGC Executive Secretary Eleanor Cardona read a statement from KOGC Administrator, former President Rodrigo Duterte, regarding the June 10 incident. The former chief executive vows accountability for what he believed were abuses.
This is a clear violation of the law. It has an overkill in any language. This act cannot go unpunished. It is unfortunate that the obsession of this administration to demonize Pastor Kibuloy even before he could be convicted by a court of law is a clear maneuver to divert attention from the deepening crisis spawned by corruption, incompetence, and abuse of authority.
KOGC officials alleged two people died during the violence triggered by the serving of the arrest warrant. They added many of their members were left traumatized aside from damage to property.
These PNP personnel proceeded right away at 3:55 a.m. to breach walls by the use of ladders insofar as the operation in CoAJC Central was conducted. Literally and forcibly broke walls at 4:49 a.m. insofar as Glory Mountain operation was concerned, and or forcibly opened gates at 5:02 a.m. and or forcibly kicked and or destroyed doors of houses.
Katulad na naman kanilang madaling araw, 2 o'clock, pumunta na naman kayo doon sa farm, ginising at pinagbabalya yung pintuan ng mga farmer doon.
Marabil, however, maintained there was no abuse.
Our personnel exercise remarkable self-restraint and maximum tolerance. Members of the Kingdom of Jesus Christ disgracefully choose to use women and children as human shields, obstructing and delaying the lawful actions of the police. Armed with bolos and other bladed weapons, male members of this group engage in violent confrontations with police officers.
De La Rosa, meanwhile, feels his phone is being monitored. The hearing will continue on August 20. RG Cruz, ABS-CBN News.
Over 1,000 fake birth certificates issued in a town in Davao del Sur. The local government of Santa Cruz revealed in a Senate hearing Monday over 50 of the cases involved foreigners, particularly Chinese nationals. Authorities also found the same midwife proven to be non-existent signed the papers, while majority of those involved cannot be found in their indicated addresses.
We chose birth certificates with foreign national sounding names. Okay. And we found out that these documents or colbies, kulang po yung mga attachments. So we concluded na irregularly issued po siya na birth certificate. And we found out na a certain job order employee po yung nag-facilitate. So as early as January 2024, hindi na namin renew yung contract ng JO.
Philippine senators suspect a syndicate may be behind the fraudulent scheme.
Let's say hindi ka Pilipino, you're running away from your country, you want to live here. Wala kang balak iscam, wala kang balak iperwisyo. Pero, or halimbawa, di ba, hindi ka nag-a-apply ng passport or birth certificate, pero gusto mong mag-drive dito or gusto mong bumili ng lupa. So, ipepekein mo para nga you can stay here. The second is, kaya mo pinipeke dahil really it's to prepare for scamming people.
We are looking into the angle that these Chinese nationals are in conspiracy with other public officials or other public private individuals.